Hello friends, in this video let's talk about one of the important concept for the Python developers. If, elif and else in Python. First of all, if is a very common concept in any technology. You might be seeing this if in programming language. You might have already seen if in RDBMS. You might have seen this if in reporting platform. In any technology, if is very quite common. But the way you handle is bit different. In programming language, you might be handling in a one way. In a RDBMS, you might be handling in a different way. In other reporting or ETL technologies, you might be handling in a different way. But the purpose of if is always the same. It is a decision making keyword which controls the execution flow. So when I say controls execution flow, see there is a condition is here. So let me simply tell you. So there is a condition is here. So there is a condition is here. So based on the condition, so let's take a flow chart like this. So you will be having a flow chart like this. So this is the condition. So I'm not good at drawing, please bear with me. So this is the condition. C is condition. So if the condition satisfies, you will go in one way, that is yes. Let us say take different color. So that is yes. If no, or if it is false, you will be going in this direction, true or false, false direction, let's no direction. So this condition is a decision making for the execution flow. So either execution should go this path or this path, my condition is taking care of that. It is a decision making. Then how to handle in Python, we are going to talk about that. So here I am going to show you practically how to handle that. So let me open a Python window. Hope you know that how to open a Python, just start. So you can simply type Python IDLE or simple IDLE. Yes, IDLE. So yeah, Python IDLE is getting open. Meanwhile, hope you are enjoying this Python video series. So please subscribe and support for more technical videos. So like this is the Python window, so where we do write if and other stuff. Okay, so before going to do that, so let's go with it. So a theoretical session for a couple of minutes. So if is a decision making term, so which controls the execution flow of a compiler, either this direction, either true direction or a false direction. Then what is a syntax? Let me write a syntax. So what is the syntax in Python? Hope you know that if condition. See this condition, you can put it in a single parenthesis, open and closed parenthesis, open and closed parenthesis, or you can leave that as a directive. It's up to you. This parenthesis is up to you. And colon, you need to keep colon. That is extra you will be keeping when you compile the programming language. And after that, enter. So you need to follow some indentation. Why indentation is in programming language? So you might be having either open and closed curly braces or begin end. So these are the statements has to execute as a part of this condition, something like that. But Python does not have these. Okay, so Python works on the indentation, white spaces. So when I say indentation, simple spaces. So one or three, four spaces, one tab space, assume it. I just pressed one tab in the notepad. It gives you a lot of space, but in the Python window, it gives you only four spaces. So here you need to follow. Here you need to start your statements because you are going to execute based on the if condition. Now you can do whatever the statement you want. So you have multiple statements. Let's start in the same position here. Next, so if you have a else, again else should start with the if position only, and again this, let's again start this as a indentation here onwards. Some, let's say I'm using as XXX. Again, same here, XXX, like this. So this is a syntax of if and else. If you do not have else, nothing to worry. If you have else, you need to write like this. So the next one is elif. I'll talk about, wait for a moment. So before, let me explain if condition here. So here, hope you know that, like whenever I type a one line, it automatically goes like this. Next command, it wait for the next command. I am going to write this block of statements in a file. So I'll execute that file directly, because I'm using direct Python IDE here. So maybe next example onwards, so I'll use either Jupyter or Spider or the other IDE for the development. So either is fine, but for time being, let's go to file, open a new file, and let's declare it now. Let's use a if condition for one of our example. So here I'm going to declare two variable, and I want to validate either both are equal or not. I can do anything. It a equal to 10, b equal to 20. So I declared two variables. Okay, so now let's use if of a condition, a equal to or a greater than, or which one is bigger number, I want to identify that quick easy. Okay, if a greater than b, so I'm using parenthesis. As I told you, parenthesis is optional, but this is essential, that colon, enter it. Once you type that colon and enter it, it means that you need to use indentation. You can see this much of indentation my compiler is going to take. It means that if success statements has to execute. Now I'm going to make it as print. I can put as a is big number. So I don't want to put any other statement. So let me go to the else part. Assume it for time being, I don't have else. Let's go here. So let's save this. So let me save somewhere in the folder here. Let's save anywhere. What I say, if save. Okay, so this is, let me go to some other folder, desktop, and save. Okay, so now let's run this. I told you how to run. Just go to run command, click on run module F5. Okay, so here, see, if you see, really see the program here. So a is 10, b is 20. That is the reason why 10 greater than 20, it is, condition doesn't satisfy. That is the reason why it is not showing. Now let me change this, a less than b. Now let me run this. Yes, you can see a is a big number, because I need to modify the message as well. It's my mistake. Let's make it as b. Okay, let's run this now. Let's save it. First of all, we need to save it. Now let's run this. Yes, b is a big number, because a is 10, b is 20, a less than b. Yes, right, that is the reason why b is big number. Now I want, if b is not a big number, I need other number should be a big number, right? So let's move, use else now. How to use else is, so let me go to this number and enter it. I am done with the success part of this if condition. Now I need to go for the fail part of it. How to do that is, else part I need to add. So where I need to write else is, else should start the same column number. So here, if you see, if I started as a column 0, same way else also should start, else colon, let's enter it. Now if you enter it, it now the my pointer is starting where the print has started. It means that my compiler or my IDE automatically knows that where should else part start. Now let's make it right. Print a is big number. I'm just, see, this is very basic example for our understanding purpose I have taken. Now, so let's save this. Let's run this. Now you can see b is a big number. Now let's change the numbers here. Now I am a making as 30. So let's run, save this first. Let's run this. Now I can see a is a big number. So now my compiler automatically identifies that based on this condition. So it is telling either b is a big number or a is a big number. So if you remember it, as I told you, this open and close parenthesis is optional. Let me remove this. I'm just showing you that as well, so that you can feel comfortable. Now let's save this. Before run it, let's save this and run this. There is no change in the execution actually. It simply says the same output. Because that is optional, I want to show, that's it. Now here I have only if and else in this condition now. Then what about, see, if this condition satisfies, it is executing this. If not satisfying, it is executing this. But I have some other condition saying that if this condition not satisfies, I want to check other condition, then only I want to go for else part. Let us say if the condition 1 does not satisfy, then I'll go to condition 2 and I'll validate it. Condition 2, then I'll write some block of statements here. So I'm making as a T. Now I'm going to else part. See, this is called as a nested if here. So here one condition 1, condition 2, and last I am going else. So do we need to keep else as mandatory? No, it is up to us. If you have a scenario where you want to say, then you need to do, otherwise nothing required. Now let's come back to our example. So here I have taken only A and B. Now I want to take C also, or let us say let me take some different case here. C equal to 30. Okay, so what I will do is let me make it as a what I'll say, C is 30. Okay, now let me use it. So if A less than B, I'm saying as a B is a big number, and I'm going to consider C as well. Let me use C. If I'm just simply using this again indentation, if you see, if I can put the here as a condition again, B less than C, I'm simply keeping this, or I need to do, what I have to do is either C is okay. So let me write, change this. So let me make it as A equal to some number 3. Okay, so now I want to say either A is a even or odd or neutral. If it is A is even or odd or 0, I want to do that. If A equal to 0, so then I want to say it is a 0, I don't need to do anything. If it is other than 0, I want to do either even or odd. So now let's do that. If so, A equal to 0, double equal to, I need to put it. Now enter it, print. So A value is 0. I'm simply keeping as 0. Okay, next, if then I'm going to, I don't want to validate it. If A equal to 0, I don't want to validate either A is even or odd. Else if A modulus whatever it is 2 equal to 0, then I want to print A is even number. Else print A is a odd number. I just created a random example for us. So if A is different value, then I'm going to validate it. I made it as A is 3, so obviously it doesn't go to this, then it comes to this else part. Now let's save this and let's run this. See, A is a odd number. Okay, so now let's go to the change, A equal to 0, save it. A value is 0. When it is A value is 0, then it's not coming. So here, see, here I have a nested if. I have I cannot call it as a nested if, I have a second if. So here, this is how we do, right? So if this condition satisfies, then compiler does not look for these two. If this condition does not satisfy, then the compiler come and check for this condition. If this condition also not works, then the compiler execute this. Because these are all command coming as a single if. At any point of time, only one block is going to execute. So if one block is executing, the other blocks doesn't execute at all, does not look at all. My compiler does not look at all for those. So this is how we do write if, elif and else. Elif is nothing but a else if actually, but in Python they just given a short word that is called as elif. Now important point here you need to understand is indentation. My compiler strictly follows the indentation. So now let me put it here. So let me put one more number here, print. Test message. I am just keeping test message. So here in the else part, I am planning to print two lines, two statements here. Okay. So now if I execute it, I'll be getting these two. Okay. So now let me add one more general statement, which is starting the column position as 0. Okay. Let me make it as print final message. Let's save this and let's run this. I think this is giving them, let me remove this. Okay, so now let me run this, let's remove that. See if you see, yeah, save it. Oh, okay, let me end that. I need to specify the string in the double quotes, right? Yeah, I missed it to that, it's my mistake, let's run this. Now if you see here, a value is 0 and its final message is also getting displayed because my compiler strictly follows the indentation. If the statement starting as a different indentation, it means that it does not relate to the if condition. That is the reason why this line executed. This line executes irrespective of these conditions. That is the reason why I am telling again and again, indentation is very much important to the Python compiler. Indentation is nothing but a white space actually, more or less. Okay, so that's all about if, elif, else in Python. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. So please like and subscribe for more technical videos. Thank you.